Here in Vermont, in good times and bad, neighbors have long looked out for each other, exchanging goods and services without using cash. Now, with a recession and rising unemployment numbers, even more people are looking for ways to get by. And so, a new old idea has taken hold: time banks.
Are you comfortable, Marge?
I am. Thank you.
Okay, great.
Marjorie Power is about to get the first facial of her life.
I would never in my imagination have ever thought of getting a facial. So it's sort of exciting.
It's an unlikely luxury in a tough economy, but this pampering is not costing the 67-year-old a cent. Instead, she's earned this through an exchange system called a time bank.
The more I've done with it, the better I like it.
A time bank is a way to give and get services without cash. Monica Kimball is the head of the Onion River Exchange in central Vermont.
It's a great way to kind of preserve and to raise your status quo without having to pay for it.
It's not a barter system where one person directly trades with another. Instead, people sign up through a website and list services they can provide and ones they want to get. For every hour you spend doing something for someone in your community, you earn 1 hour of credit. At the Onion River Exchange, there are 365 services being offered.
For example, one woman earned credits cooking or something, and she got piano lessons for her granddaughter.
New members have trouble, for instance, going into deficit before they've earned anything. I can't spend, I don't have any money. But of course it isn't money, and you can go into deficit. And so it's, you have to get yourself in a whole different non-commercial mindset, non-money mindset.
The Onion River Exchange started a year ago with 70 people. Now there are over 240 members. The hours of services this month already are almost double that of last month.
It's kind of great because, well, the economy is going so downhill, it's really an ideal time to be running a time bank, you know, because people need those other ways to get things done.
Marjorie Power earned her credit that she redeemed at the spa by making dinner for Colin Gunn.
Hey, Colin.
Hey, Marge.
Soup's up.
Oh, great.
24-year-old Gunn was one of the founding members of the Onion River Exchange.
What do we got?
It's zucchini bisque. It's vegetarian, not vegan, and not for people with coronary problems.
In addition to meals, Gunn also uses the time bank to get help around the house with repairs.
I've put up requests for things that I find myself really needing, but don't necessarily have the money to hire people to help me with. It certainly helps in that I don't need money in order to make a request through the Onion River Exchange. All I need is the ability to have something else to offer, which everybody does.
He's handy, so to earn his dinner, he responded to a request by Monica Kimball to fix an old record player she got free.
Do you think he can fix it?
Yeah, I think so.
Great.
People who participate in time banks say it also helps remind people who are cash-strapped or unemployed that they have worth.
Being able to give those things, to see that you are really important, that you're vital to your community, is really empowering for people.
There are three other time banks in Vermont, in Burlington, Middlebury, and Barnard. To sign up for the Onion River Exchange, it costs $25 a year, and you don't need a computer. You can check out services in the office at City Hall, and there are also people who offer their computers for use.
What does the time bank do that people or community couldn't do on its own?
Ideally, nothing. Our ultimate goal is to not exist. But in the meantime, it provides the community a way to connect people who would never otherwise meet.
Good, how are you?
Monica Kimball earned her record player repair by volunteering at the Restore in Barrie, Vermont. The nonprofit collects used items and business surplus and sells them cheap.
What did you first think when you heard of this idea of time banking?
Well, I didn't really know what it meant, but then I was able to talk with a coordinator and she was able to explain that it's not a direct, you know, exchange. It's sort of like a barter network.
With grant programs being cut, the Restore relies on time bank volunteers.
in this, you know, economic climate, this kind of creative response to people needing services is going to be the way of the future.
Back at the spa, Marjorie Powers enjoying her facial earned through the time bank.
At first, when you go in, you kind of treat your credits like money. So you tend to save them because we're all supposed to be saving. But that's not how it works. You have to treat them as, if I hoard these, I'm breaking the system down. So it's one of the few occasions where you can really spend without feeling guilty.
The Holistica Spa is less than a year old and signed up for the time bank to bring in new customers.
Some people might think it's counterintuitive for a business to be giving away a service. So how does this help the business?
Actually, I found that a lot of the clients that I have through OAR talk about it with their friends, and word of mouth in such a small community is very valuable for us. And this is a tough time for us, and we really feel like the community has supported us and we're supporting the community.
A time bank chain running through New England as people and businesses find ways to get through the recession without using cash.